Henry Winkler, a.k.a. the Fonz, had a few choice words for Georgia Senate candidate and former football star Herschel Walker. It all started when Walker was asked about the nation's biggest issue. The famous athlete's answer, famous people, he said, giving advice. And speaking on a political podcast, Walker said, quote, some of the biggest problems going on in our country today, we have so many celebrities telling people they can't do it. He goes on to say, I think they tell all the kids they can't do it, making our kids feel sorry for themselves. Of course, Herschel Walker is a famous person himself. That drew a response from Henry Winkler, who tweeted, I need to repeat this again. I am an American first with every right to an opinion. Then I am an actor. That is Henry Winkler's response to Herschel Walker, and Henry Winkler of Happy Days fame and so many other just incredible roles over the years. He joins me now, and it's such an honor to have you here. We should point out Henry Winkler currently stars on the great TV show Barry on HBO, which is owned by the same parent company as CNN. And we should also know we did ask Herschel Walker if he'd like to talk to us today. We did not get a response. But Henry, great to see you. Thanks so much for doing this.
Thank you.
Why did you decide to speak out?
You know, well, the general premise has bothered me forever. I always thought it was so weird. So many people use that kind of tactic of saying, oh, you're on television, you shouldn't say what you think. And I'm thinking that is the craziest thing I ever heard. And then when I saw Mr. Walker's tweet, I thought to myself, first of all, we are, profession, we are uplifting. That's number one. Number two, why shouldn't I have the same point of view? He has the right to. He is a celebrity. What is he talking about? He talks about being an absentee father. He has a couple of children he hasn't even mentioned, nor has seen. That we can say anything for a vote is nauseating.
And you don't hide your political preferences, Henry. You take part in Democratic fundraisers. You're public about who you support, who you don't. Tell us about how you feel about these upcoming midterms. There are a lot of predictions of a red wave coming as President Biden and the Democrats deal with these high gas prices, inflation, and so on. What do you think? How do you see this upcoming cycle shaping up?
I have no idea if this is what is happening. I have an overall view that if autocracy takes over, they will no longer need the vote. If they no longer need the vote, the people that are working so hard and are so excited about winning are going to be kicked to the curb eventually because they will no longer be needed. I predict that to be a truth. But if this is the way, we are a great country. We have survived ups and downs. I have grandchildren, and I hope they live the same wonderful ability to dream the way I did. My parents escaped Nazi Germany. I'm first generation American. I'm very proud of it. And I'm getting to do what I dreamt of doing when I was seven.
Yeah. Well, and you do it so well. I mean, we're going to talk about Barry in a moment, which is a great show. But I got to admit, I grew up, I'm a first generation American too. My dad is a Cuban refugee, but you know, I grew up in Northern Virginia, right outside Washington, D.C., and one of my favorite memories was getting around the television with my folks and watching shows like Happy Days. I mean, that was just my childhood. And so I hope you don't mind me asking you about this, but Happy Days depicted a scene. It didn't delve into politics too much, but there was an episode where Fonzie was campaigning for Dwight D. Eisenhower. We have to show this and get your take on it on the other side.
Now listen, if Ike loses, Fonz is going to be mad. But hey, I like Ike. My bike likes Ike. So get out of work for the old guy. And one more thing, huh? For all you volunteers at the Eisenhower booth, there's free root beer and hot dogs, huh?
Henry, you're pretty good at that, I got to say. I mean, you know. My bike likes Ike. And we haven't had a shot there of Mr. and Mrs. C. as you used to refer to them back in the day. When you consider everything that's going on right now with, this toxic, stew that we have brewing here in Washington, we may not be out of the woods yet when it comes to our democracy. Gosh, that image there of you campaigning for Eisenhower, it just seems so far away.
You know, I bet that entire scene was based on the joke, "My bike likes Ike." You know, I think they probably wrote the entire thing just for me to say that. But, what is so, the ability for the American community to listen has so diminished that when that takes a turn, possibly everything else will go with it, you know? I have an overview thought that we as a country, we care more about the profit than we do about the population of 300 plus million people. That is sad.
And you have this terrific show, Barry, on HBO. People have been raving about your role on the show. But I have to ask you about this. There's a new open letter signed by over 200 actors, filmmakers, producer types, people like J.J. Abrams, Mark Ruffalo, Shonda Rhimes, urging the entertainment industry to be more mindful of gun use, how they're portrayed on screen and films and on TV shows, and it says, and I'll put it up on screen, "As America's storytellers, our goal is primarily to entertain, but we also acknowledge that stories have the power to affect change. Cultural attitudes toward smoking, drunk driving, seatbelts, marriage equality all have evolved due in large part to movies and TV's influence. It's time to take on gun safety." You're on a show that's currently about a hitman trying to transition out of the business. How much responsibility do you think Hollywood has right now when it comes to these depictions of violence with so much gun violence going on in this country right now?
Well, first of all, that is a very good question. And second of all, I'm very proud to be a part of shows. The Fonz, we did a show about wearing glasses. We did a show about going to the library and that you could take a book out for free. Barry is a young man who is troubled and complicated and is trying very hard to leave the gun behind and hopefully eventually will make it. But yes, we do have a voice in that we do, we can present a point of view and then leave it up to the public to go, oh my goodness, that's a good idea. I think maybe I can follow that.
Absolutely. And we've seen it time and again throughout our history, these cultural influences that we have coming out of Hollywood having a positive effect on society, sometimes not so positive. But Henry Winkler, maybe you'll get to that point with the great Bill Hader on Barry. It's a terrific program. That would be a great ending to the show.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for your time. And we should note, we don't have time to show it right now, but I love the tweets of you fishing out in the wilderness there. That looked like a lot of fun, too.
Do you know what? I just came back this morning from the river in Idaho, which is, talk about transformational. But I will end by saying this. There is a wonderful lawyer who is an acquaintance of ours who said, it is not about the money. It's only about the money.
All right, Henry Winkler, thank you so much. We appreciate it. Good to see you, sir. And we'll hopefully talk to you again soon. We appreciate it so much. Quick break.
I hope so. Have a great summer.